Hello friends, welcome to engineering tutorial. In my previous video, I discussed about some of the basic concepts related to inductors, where we discussed about the definition of inductors, the voltage and current across the inductors, the voltage induced in a inductor coil and the current flow, the expressions, the formula for voltage and inductor voltage and current associated with inductor coils, and we also discussed about the alternative interpretation of inductors, the another mathematical expression for inductors which is used in designing of inductive sensors and transducers in industrial instrumentation. So in today's video, we are going to take that discussion a little bit forward, and we are going to discuss about series and parallel combination of inductors and circuits. Okay, so we will discuss about the expression of equivalent inductance of a number of inductors when they are connected in series in a circuit. So here you can see that this is a circuit where there are n number of inductors, okay, L1, L2, and similarly there are L3, L4 up to Ln. There are n number of inductors that are connected in series across a DC voltage source V. Now you can say that they are connected in series because the end of one inductor, okay, is connected to the end of the other. Means the right end of this inductor L1 is connected to the left end of inductor L2. Similarly, the right end of inductor L2 is connected to the left end of L3, and so on. I already discussed about the end-to-end connection in the series connection of resistors. By looking at a circuit, you can say that whether the circuit elements are connected in series or parallel. So now, the expression of equivalent inductance means the total inductance of this circuit, taking into account the inductors L1, L2, L3, L4, L5 up to Ln. The total inductance is given by this expression. L equivalent, or the total inductance of the circuit, is equal to the sum of the individual inductances. That is L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus L4 plus up to Ln. Okay, so this is the expression for equivalent inductance. Now here we have just written it like this, that is, the equivalent inductance formula is L1 plus L2, means the sum of the individual inductances. But how we got this expression, okay, that is more important. So now we are going to derive this expression for equivalent inductance of a number of inductors connected in series. So now we are going to derive the expression of equivalent inductance of a number of inductors connected in series. So we have taken the same circuit that we just saw previously, where there are n number of inductors L1, L2, L3 up to Ln connected in series across a DC voltage source V, and the current flowing through the circuit is small I. Okay. So as it is a series connection, the current through each of these inductor coils L1, L2 and L3 up to Ln is the same. The same current small I flows through these inductors. So if we apply KVL in this closed loop, now before that, VL1, VL2, VL3 up to VLn are the voltage which is developed across the inductor coils L1, L2, L3 and Ln. Okay, VL1, VL2, VL3 up to VLn are the voltages that develop across L1, L2, L3 and Ln. Now pay attention to the polarity which I have given. It is plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. It is because it is measured in the same direction to which the polarity which is placed with reference to the current flow through the inductor coil. The current always flows from positive to negative terminal internally through the inductor, okay, because inductors absorb power. So that's why the polarity is given in this way. I have already discussed about that in the basic concepts related to inductors in the introductory part, so please check out that part. Okay, so if we apply KVL in this closed loop, we will get the total voltage or the applied voltage, DC voltage V, is equal to VL1 VL2 plus VL3 plus VLN. It is the sum of the individual inductor voltages, okay, if we apply KVL in this closed loop. Now we know that the voltage across an inductor is given by L dI/dt. The voltage is directly proportional to the rate of change of current flowing through the inductor coil, and the constant of proportionality is inductance L. VL is equal to L dI/dt. Now suppose the total equivalent inductance of this combination, this series combination, be it L equivalent. The total current is small I, which is the same through all of these coils. So we can write, substitute V as L equivalent dI/dt. The total voltage V is equal to L equivalent into dI/dt. So we substituted V with L equivalent dI/dt. Now the voltage across inductor L1 can be written as L1 dI/dt, because the current flowing through inductor L1 is same I. Similarly, VL2 can be written as L2 dI/dt. Similarly, VL3 can be written as L3 dI/dt, and VLN can be written as LN dI/dt. Now these are the expressions for the individual inductor voltages. Now this is the total voltage. V is equal to L equivalent dI/dt. So that's why we have used the total inductance here, which is the equivalent inductance of the series combination, and here these are the expressions for the individual inductor voltages, which involve the individual inductances. But as the same current flows through the series connection of inductors, the current in each of these expressions is the same I. Okay, so dI/dt is common in each of these expressions. You can see in each of these expressions dI/dt is common. So we can write L equivalent dI/dt is equal to L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus up to LN multiplied with dI/dT. Now dI/dT gets cancelled from both the LHS and the RHS. So we get the equivalent inductance, so the total inductance of this series circuit as L equivalent is equal to L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus LN. Okay, so we just proved that the equivalent inductance of a number of inductors connected in series is the sum of the individual inductances. Okay, the sum of all the inductances, the inductors involved in the circuit. If there are n number of inductors connected in the circuit, then it is the sum of the inductance of the in n individual inductors. Okay, simply the sum. Now you can see that this formula is similar to the series combination of resistors. There also the equivalent resistance is the sum of the individual resistances. So the formula for equivalent resistance and inductance in series is the same. Okay, so this is the derivation, mathematical derivation of the expression of equivalent inductance for a number of inductors connected in series. So now we are going to discuss about the parallel connection of inductors. Okay, so here we have this circuit diagram where there are three inductors L1, L2 and L3 which are connected in parallel. So you can say by just looking at this circuit that these three inductors are connected in parallel because the left end of these three inductors, okay, the left ends of each of the three inductors are connected together at one common point, and the right ends are connected at one common point, and those two common points are connected across the positive and negative terminals of this DC voltage source. So the ends of these three inductors are connected at the same two points, means they are connected across the same voltage source V. So one of the unique properties of the parallel connection of inductors or parallel connection of capacitors or resistors or any circuit element is that the voltage across the parallelly connected element, okay, all the parallelly connected elements is the same. So the voltage across L1 will also be V, the voltage across L2 will also be V, and the voltage across L3 will also be V. The same voltage will appear across each of the three inductors. So this is the parallel connection of inductors. Now let I be the total current flowing through the three inductors. Now I1, I2 and I3 are the individual inductor currents. I is the total circuit current. Here it gets divided into three individual inductor currents. I is the total current, I1, I2 and I3 are the individual inductor currents. And let L equivalent be the total equivalent inductance of this parallel combination of inductors L1, L2 and L3. So this is the expression for equivalent inductance when the inductors are connected in parallel. 1 by L equivalent is equal to 1 by L1 plus 1 by L2 plus 1 by L3. If there are n number of inductors, then this expression will continue up to 1 by Ln. Here we have used only 3 inductors up to L3. Excuse me. So this expression is similar to the expression of equivalent resistance for a number of resistors connected in parallel. Okay, 1 by R equivalent is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Okay, so it is similar to that. So the expression of equivalent resistance and equivalent capacitance for both series and parallel combination is the same. Next, we are going to derive this expression. How we got this expression? So now we are going to derive the mathematical expression for equivalent inductance for a number of inductors connected in parallel connection. So you can see this is the circuit diagram for a number of inductors connected in parallel. Now I have already explained about parallel connection in my video related to parallel combination of resistors. Now we can say that a number of circuit elements are connected in parallel when one end of all the circuit elements are combined together and connected at one common point, and the other end of the same circuit elements are combined together and connected at one common point, and both those points are connected across a voltage source. Okay, and another important characteristic of parallel combination is that the voltage across all the parallelly connected elements is the same. So here there are three inductors which we have taken, which are connected in parallel, with the left end of the three inductors are connected at one common point and the right ends of the three inductors are connected at one common point, and both those common points are connected to the positive and negative terminals of a DC voltage source. Now the voltage across each of the three parallelly connected inductors L1, L2 and L3 is the same, that is V. So the voltage across L1 is also V, the voltage across L2 is also V, and the voltage across L3 is also V. That is the characteristic of parallel connection. But the current flowing through each of these three inductors will be different, I1, I2 and I3. In series connection, the voltage across the three inductors or the inductors connected in series are different. Okay, the voltages are different, but the current flowing through them is the same. But here it is the opposite. The voltage across the inductors which are connected in parallel is same, but the current flow through them is different. So if we apply KCL at this node or at this point, we will get the total current I, small I, is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. That is the current flow through L1, L2 and L3. Okay, I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. This is the KCL equation. Now we know that the current flowing through an inductor is given by this expression. We have already discussed that in the basic concepts video related to inductors, where we discussed about the voltage induced across an inductor and the current flow through an inductor, those expressions. So we studied that the current flow through an inductor is given by this expression, 1 by L integration of the DC voltage source, or the applied voltage. Here we have used a DC voltage. So the applied voltage is integrated from limit minus phi to t. Okay, 1 by L minus phi to t VDT, that is the expression for inductor current. Now let the total equivalent inductance of this parallelly connected inductor circuit be L equivalent. So this total current I here can be substituted by this expression, 1 by total inductance integrated with the total voltage from limit minus phi to t dt. Okay, so this is the expression for total current, which this small I, which is replaced by this expression, where L equivalent is the total inductance. Now the individual currents I1, I2 and I3 can be written as I1 is equal to 1 by L1 integration of V from minus phi to t, I2 is 1 by L2 minus phi to t V dt, and I3 is 1 by L3 minus phi to t V dt. Now you can see that in both the LHS and the RHS, the integration of V dt is common because it is a parallelly connected circuit and the voltage across each of the parallelly connected elements is the same. That is the property of parallel connection. The voltage across all the parallelly connected elements will be the same. But only the individual inductances are different. Here for calculation of total current, we use the total inductance. And here for the calculation of the individual inductor current, we use the individual inductance. So if we cancel out this term minus phi to t V dt from both the LHS and the RHS by taking this common, okay, we have taken minus phi to t V dt common and we got 1 by L equivalent minus phi to t V dt is equal to, by taking minus phi to t common, we get 1 by L1 plus 1 by L2 plus 1 by L3 minus phi to t V dt. And if we cancel this from LHS and RHS, we get 1 by L equivalent is equal to 1 by L1 plus 1 by L2 plus 1 by L3. This is the expression for equivalent inductance for a number of inductors connected in parallel. If there would have been n number of inductors connected in parallel, it would have been 1 by L equivalent is equal to 1 by L1 plus 1 by L2 plus 1 by L3 plus 1 by L4 plus 1 by L5 up to n number of inductors plus 1 by Ln. So you can see that this expression is similar to the expression of equivalent resistance for a number of resistors connected in parallel. It is the same. So the expressions for series and parallel combination of both resistors and inductors, they have the same expression. Okay, they obey the same mathematical expression. R1 by R equivalent is also 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 up to for n number of resistors connected in parallel. Here also for inductance, 1 by L equivalent is equal to 1 by L1 plus 1 by L2 plus 1 by L3. So this is the mathematical expression for the equivalent inductance of a number of inductors connected in parallel. Okay, so here we have discussed about the mathematical derivation of the expressions for equivalent inductance when the inductors are connected in series and when they are connected in parallel. So I hope you like this video, and please subscribe my channel Engineering Tutorial for more such videos related to electrical, electronics, instrumentation and communication engineering. Have a great day. Thank you very much.